For this video, we're going to use an account that has a little more information in it so you can see how your ActiveCampaign account will eventually look. To access automations, click Automations on the left side menu. If you already have automations created in your account, they will be listed on the overview page, like how you see here. We'll default to display 10 automations per page. However, you can temporarily change the number of automations displayed per page to 20, 50, or 100 by selecting any one of the options in the rows dropdown. This option is located at the bottom of the page. To create a new automation, click the New Automation button located on the top right and follow the prompts. Below the New Automation button is the Filter toolbar. Here you can filter automations by different automation triggers and actions, by automation status, by any label you've created, or sort automations by last edited, highest activity, oldest created, newest created, alphabetical A through Z, or alphabetical Z through A. Clicking the checkbox below the Filter by Actions option will select all automations displayed on the current page. You can use this to perform bulk actions with your selected automations, such as add or remove a label or create a new label. You can also set the selected automations to active, inactive, or delete them. You can also perform these same actions with an individual automation by clicking the checkbox to the left. If you have a lot of automations in your account, you can use a search field to the right to search for one by its title. Under the filter bar, you'll see all automations that you've created. Each automation will have a thumbnail that provides a screenshot of how it looks. If you see a red dot, then that means the automation has an inactive status. And this green dot that you see right here means it has an active status. You'll also see the automation name, labels applied to the automation, and an option to add a label. To the right, you'll see that each automation has its own stats. The contact stat in lighter blue will show the number of contacts that are currently moving through your automation. This will not include contacts who have already completed your automation. Clicking the link contained in this stat will bring you to a list of those contacts. The campaign stat in darker blue shows the number of campaigns contained in the automation as well as the open rate for each campaign. Clicking the name of the campaign will bring you to the individual report for that email. The goal stat in yellow will show all actions contained in your automation as well as the goal completion rate. Clicking the name of the goal will bring you to the individual report for that goal. In addition to stats, each automation will have an edit button. Clicking the edit button for an automation will open the workflow builder so you can make any necessary modifications to it. Clicking the down caret for any automation will allow you to either make it active or inactive, view the contacts in the automation, create a sharing link so the automation can be imported by another user, create a copy of the automation, set user permissions, or delete the automation. If you want to see which triggers your automations are using, you can do so by clicking the Show Start Triggers link on the top right. Over to the left, you'll see Manage Messages. Clicking this option will list all automations in your account, along with the number of messages each one has. Clicking the down caret will display a list of messages in an automation, along with message type, when it was last sent, and an option to either delete or edit the message. Finally, we have the Automations map. This map will give you an overview of your automations and show you how they're connected. In addition, you can see the map for each individual automation in your account by hovering your mouse over the automation name and clicking the icon that appears.